Nice to have you back. David Gann here, CEO of DNY Laboratories, the manufacturer of double helix water. On our last video, we began visiting the subject of self-healing. Now, I believe we can make an assumption here, and that is that even within the Western medical community, one would find a complete consensus that self-healing, or actual healing, happens because of the information that's stored within our DNA. We heal, basically our body gets well, because of instructions that are found within our DNA. So let's take a few minutes to look at this. To begin, what could we establish as the purpose of DNA? In other words, what has DNA been doing all this time since life began here on Earth? May seem like a big question, but actually it's not that difficult to answer, because DNA has had one purpose, one intention, one directive since it began, and that is survive. It's only motivated by the continuance of life. And it's done a good job, wouldn't you agree? I'm here and you're here and everyone is here because it worked. Now, how has nature's remarkable mechanism or device or technology or whatever we want to call it, we're talking here about DNA. How has DNA kept this race of humans and all living creatures alive for the millennia? Well, basically it's kept good notes. It's kept a running record of all its successes, how it fixed itself as well as how it replicated itself. For how long? Well, like we said in the last video, most scientists would agree that it's somewhere around 3.5 billion years. So the DNA that's inside of you, the DNA that's inside of me, and the DNA that's in every living creature on Earth has been around for 3.5 billion years, and it's been learning that entire time. It's not like it's been dead and then it was born and then it was dead and then it was born. No, it's been alive for those 3.5 billion years as it was always passed down through generations living. You got your DNA from your parents. They got their DNA when your parents were alive, and they got their from their parents, and again, they were living, and on and on and on. So the DNA that's in all of us has been alive for 3.5 billion years. Now, what would be a good estimate if we wanted some comparison of how much information is stored in a single strand, microscopic strand of DNA? Be about 6 gigabits. That's like having every living person on Earth hold a sign up over their head with one bit of information on that sign. But this is a record. It's not like there's a little known inside your head with a pencil that's writing down this information. It's not an actual written record in print, but what you have is a geometric arrangement of a plus and a minus. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, medicine would say that there are 4 different kinds of body chemistry that make up stuff that we call DNA. And they call these bases or building blocks. They say that the arrangement of these building blocks is how and how they line up and fit together writes this code, this DNA code. But if you actually look below that understanding, we find that there's a prior code underneath that, because those building blocks are made of something, and those somethings are made from basic elements, and those elements stick together because of little charges, either a push or a pull, a plus or a minus. So there's a difference here when one views this from a chemical or biological point of view or a physical basis. Biological and chemical systems can seem rather complex, but from a physics point of view, it's simply a long chain of places where something will either bond or not bond. Something will stick or not stick. So in that sense, we're looking at a very simple binary code. Now, binary code is a language or the brain you find in your computer. It's a code built of two values, either a 1 and a 0, or an on or an off, or a plus or a minus, or a dot and dash if we're talking about a Morse code. So if we look at this, below all this complexity of biological systems, which are being cluttered also with labels from Latin, below that is a simple, simple mechanism. Basically, our body. It began with DNA way back in a watery ocean. It began simply as something that would either bond or not bond, stick or not stick. And it's a rather sad commentary on our society today that we strive to make these subjects so complex. Because in truth, you, me, all our friends, all our family, everyone on earth, on an actual fundamental basis, all bodies are made of little things that either want to push or pull, attract or repel, stick or not stick. And that's it. No matter how many old professors speak Latin to us, nothing changes that. So another way to view your body is to realize on a most primary basis, the function, in other words, how it operates, is dead simple. It can appear very complex. And don't get me wrong, even if you strip away all the Latin labels, it will still look very complex. But there's a simple answer as to why it appears so complicated, and that is number. There are billions, trillions of these simple, non-complicated processes occurring at any given moment. So it's easy to become overwhelmed simply because of the number of processes. It's like if you looked out your front door and saw one friend. You would not be shocked or overwhelmed, but if you looked out that same door and saw a trillion friends, well, you get the idea. Function, how it operates, is dead simple. It is the number of concurrent processes that makes it appear so complex. All right, let's look at this line of chemistry. Now, we don't need to get very significant about what this chemistry is, but basically it's a piece of body chemistry that has to replicate exactly to the next generation of cells. And these are just simple little elements in your body that should be there. They're natural elements, but what happens when you ingest toxins? Toxins then are in the soup of the cell, and rather than picking up these little simple elements, look what happens. Toxins fly in and bond, stick to the body chemistry. So what this means is that this piece of body chemistry is no longer useful to the body. Now it's stupid. It can't protect you from viruses or bacteria or parasites or whatever the particular protein or body chemistry is needed for. You don't have it anymore because of toxins.
Your body is a simple replication process. That is, this code that we've been talking about, it basically reproduces itself because of places that things will stick or bond or don't stick or don't bond. So there's one good point here to understand with this particular video, and that is what goes into your body could very well end up sticking to another piece of body chemistry. And if that body chemistry is part of DNA, you could very well be affecting your genetic code. Linus Pauling is a person in history, only person in history, that was awarded two unshared Nobel Prizes and was probably one of the most influential chemists that ever lived. And he was somewhat direct about what his viewpoint on what should be added to the body. Famous quote by Pauling is, "Everything in the treatment and prevention of chronic diseases, which is not orthomolecular, which means natural to the body, will fail." So he went on to say that no matter how many marketing dollars you threw at unnatural substances in an attempt to make them workable solutions, it was useless. Because in the end, you, me, all of us are natural 3 billion year old creatures that Mother Nature made. Man-made chemicals, which have been shown up in the last 100 years, won't fit into her basic plan. Basically, they act as toxins to you. Double helix water has to be one of, if not the most natural product in existence. The difference is that my physicist research partner and I have uncovered another phase of water, one that we are convinced has been around since DNA began. We have spent years learning how to concentrate it. It's a little water particle, a little water molecule that your body is totally able to work with. And because it has a bigger push or bigger pull, in other words, from a physics point of view, it has a larger charge. And because of that larger charge, it simply has the ability to do more work. Life has been doing work for billions of years. It's been going strong, working, working, working. It's a constantly working water machine. It knows exactly what to do. What you want to do is enhance it, not poison it.